work with a local artist who's quite well known, and we solicited lots of artists, and they made brand new work for us. And in this initiative, the artwork is now going, it's destined for staff rooms.
Is it?
Which is very unusual, because normally we just have enough budget and energy and resources to do patients.
Yeah, so it keeps the staff morale high as
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely, and so far, I mean, you'll find out later if our staff love it, but I think they do.
And do you get a lot of good feedback from patients outcome?
Yes, yeah. We have a kind of a rolling, it used to be letters, and now it's emails, and now sometimes it's, you know, WhatsApps or whatever, tweets.
Yeah.
So we keep a file by that. There seems to be a nice response again. This may be people's first encounter with art ever, so it's an opportunity to, and a privilege to bring great, significant, meaningful. Make a limited edition prints that we pay for, we produce, and then we sell them. All the money comes right back to the hospital, and then each artist nominates a health charity. So we split the proceeds. So it's a way for the artists to extend their work, because, for example, some of these are deep in isolation wards, and you can't see the artwork. So it's a way for them to have an outward, and also to raise money for charity.
And it's just so wonderful to work on
her. Yeah, I think it's such, I honestly couldn't think about it better. And it's great. I don't realize actually the gallery itself have got a massive history of simulation tools that tell us this group, which I'm really
great because there's no space on the walls. So why not have the curtain carry a panoramic image? So it's the tens, it's a painful image.
Yeah.
What you didn't see, but Lem, I think, told you.
I guess this is a free conversation.
How are you all doing? It's been such a challenging time. I know hospitals are busy places anyway, but you know the extra pressures of COVID and pandemic last year. But how's the mood now? You know, obviously, it seems to be light at the end of the tunnel. But how's everyone doing? How's morale?
Yeah, I think morale's good. We've come through the last few months of being pretty tough. We knew something was going to happen again in November, so everyone was kind of thinking about stepping up, but we didn't know what was going to hit us again. And I think it was a really, really challenging time in terms of looking after the number of patients that we got.